So students, today I will going to discuss about the process translation. Translation means formation of protein from RNA. This is called translation. So first we have to go through the requirements, means what are the things that are needed in translation process. First mRNA, second tRNA, ribosomes, an enzyme, aminosyl tRNA synthetase, and some specific amino acids. So these are the basic requirements of the translation process. Okay, actually ribosome is a cell organelle that is present in the cytoplasm of the cell, and protein synthesis mainly occurs over the ribosomes. But these ribosomes has two subunit. Okay, actually these two subunits are not joined with each other during the process. First these two subunits of ribosomes come together, okay, and then protein synthesis is started. And when the two subunits of ribosome joined with each other, this process is called association. And for the association of the two subunits of the ribosome, magnesium ion presence is necessary. Okay, and when the protein synthesis is complete, means DNA translation is complete, again the two subunits of the ribosomes become separated. This is called dissociation. Means when these two subunits combined with each other, it's called association. When these two subunits disassociates with each other, it's called disassociation. Okay, so ribosomes two subunits are not same. One is the larger subunit, one is the smaller subunit. It has a groove for pushing out the newly formed polypeptide, protecting the same from cellular enzymes. Okay, the larger subunit contains a groove or channel through which the new polypeptide or the proteins that are synthesized, they are pushed out through this groove, because protein synthesis occurs within the ribosome. And smaller subunit fits over the larger one like a cap, leaves a tunnel for mRNA. Means in the, see, this is the smaller subunit, this is the larger subunit. This smaller, larger subunit and smaller subunit fitted with each other, and at the middle portion there is a channel or tunnel through which the mRNA is passed. This is the mRNA. So this is the larger subunit, smaller subunit, and this is the mRNA. These usually form helical groups during active protein synthesis, known as polyribosomes or polysomes. Means in a mRNA chain, so many ribosomes attached. Here in a diagram, only one ribosomes diagram is given. But in this time of translation, so many number of ribosomes are attached and form a polyribosome. Okay, here it is written, different ribosomes of a polysome are held together by a strand of mRNA. Through the strand of mRNA, so many ribosomes are held together. Clear? Now, parts of ribosomes. Actually, the ribosomes have so many parts. A channel for mRNA that lies between the two subunit, larger subunit, smaller subunit. In between them, this is the channel or tunnel through which this mRNA is passed. Okay? And there are some sites. Three reactive sites are there. P site, A site, and E site. P site means peptidyl transferase or donor site. This is called P site, middle portion. Actually, in this site, tRNA comes and it binds with the codon of this mRNA. Okay? In the letter, it will be clear. A site or aminosyl or acceptor site. This is the A site, which is situated on the larger subunit of mRNA. It is situated on the larger subunit. And E site or exit site, from this site it facing the tunnel site. Just it is the tunnel site. Here it is present. This is the E site. So these are the three sites of ribosomes, and which type of events takes places in these particular sites, we will discuss it. Okay, now messenger RNA. In the diagram we have found that messenger RNA is also required. It is messenger RNA which brings the coded information from DNA. Actually, for translation, within the messenger RNA there are so many codons are there, means nucleotides are there, which brings the coded information from DNA, because from DNA messenger RNA is transcribed. Codons of mRNA are not recognized by amino acids. They are but by anticodons of their adapter molecules or tRNA. In this way, this is the mRNA. In the mRNA, A, U, G, U, G, in this way, codons are present and these are recognized by the anticodon. Means in their disposition, anticodons of the tRNA are present. So if there are A, U, G, it means that it is specified by, recognized by the anticodon UAC. Your AU, AU, CG will bonded. So these are the anticodons of tRNA or adapted molecules. Translation occurs over the ribosomes. Means translation takes place within the ribosome because we have found that in this way mRNA is placed in between the two subunits of the ribosomes. Second, the same mRNA may be used time and again. Means one mRNA is used for many times, means again and again. In the form of polysome, it can help synthesize a number of copies simultaneously. Polysome means, in the diagram, only one ribosome is attached with the mRNA. Polysome means so many ribosomes are attached with the mRNA, and that's why at a single time, simultaneously, so many number of protein can be synthesized or polypeptide can be synthesized. Okay, this is the mRNA. Now tRNA. tRNA means transfer RNA or soluble RNA, picks up the particular amino acids in the process called charging. Suppose this is the tRNA, okay, and this is the mRNA. tRNA having three anticodon, UAC, which recognize the codon AUG of the mRNA, and this particular tRNA brings one amino acid which binds with its 3' end. And which amino acid will be binded with this tRNA, it depends on the codon of mRNA. Here AUG is present, it means it specifies the amino acid methionine, because we know that AUG codes for methionine. So the mRNA, the codon is AUG, it means that it brings the amino acid which is methionine. And where it is bind, it binds with the 3' end. And this process is called the charging of tRNA. Charged tRNA take the same to the mRNA over particular codon corresponding to their anticodon. So it means that it brings methionine. It has the anticodon UAC which binds with AUG. Clear? A tRNA can pick up only a specific amino acid. Through an amino acid can be specified by 2 by 6 tRNA. It means that one tRNA can pick up only a specific amino acid. This is one amino acid, one tRNA, it brings only one amino acid. But sometimes, same amino acid can be specified by 2 or 6 tRNA. Means, this tRNA again pick the amino acid methionine. Again, methionine can be picked up by another tRNA also. Somewhat 2 to 6 tRNA can bring up same amino acid. Each tRNA has an area for coming in contact with ribosome and enzyme aminosyl tRNA synthesis. Actually, in that previous class, tRNA having some structures means this loop binds with the aminosyl synthesis or the enzyme. Okay, these sides bind with the anticodon of mRNA. This 3' end binds with the amino acids. Okay, and this loop binds with the ribosomes. So it has a particular structure and having some different zones for different binding sites. And at last about the enzyme, that is aminosyl tRNA synthetase. It is the enzyme that helps in combining amino acid to the particular tRNA. Means for charging of tRNA, means when this amino acid binds with this tRNA, an enzyme is required, that is aminosyl tRNA synthetase. The enzyme is specific for each amino acid and it is also called activating enzyme because it helps to charge the tRNA, that's why it is called activating enzyme. So these are the requirements for the translation. Next we will discuss about the mechanism.